Deborah Borchardt, and this is your Marijuana Money Minute. This week, CEO Hadley Ford resigned from Ianthus Capital Holdings. The company had received some allegations from an online research firm, and as a result, they formed a special committee to investigate those allegations. As a result of their investigation, they determined a couple of these things were true, that Hadley Ford did not disclose some personal loans that he had done. As a result, he resigned. The company's president and co-founder, Randy Maslow, has stepped up to become the interim CEO. High Times is buying 13 planned and operational dispensary licenses from Harvest Health and Recreation. These are located in California. The company is paying $5 million. The rest is in stock, and the deal is valued at $80 million overall. It's part of High Times' overall strategy to pivot over to the dispensary side of the industry. Cresco Labs reported their fourth quarter 2019 earnings. Revenues came in at $41 million. This was up 144% year over year and a sequential increase of 14%. Now, the company said that the increase in revenue was due to expansion in new markets and the states where they're already operating. The net loss for the fourth quarter was $45 million, and this is much more than the net loss the same time period in 2018, which was $4.4 million. The cannabis e-commerce vendor budtrader.com is going to be going public through a reverse takeover with Lake Victoria Mining Company. This is a privately held company. They are known for their business name of P5 Systems. They have operated BudTrader since 2016. And also LVCA, Lake Victoria, is a control affiliate of Grapefruit, which owns some California permits and licenses to both manufacture and distribute cannabis products. The holding company, known for its variety of biotech names, Orthogonal Thinker, raised $6 million in an oversubscribed seed round. They're going to be using that money for their EI Ventures, which is part of their psychedelic portfolio, and to begin phase one clinical trials for Silly, which is their flagship psychedelic product. And then finally, Canopy Growth said that they were going to lay off another 200 employees. This brings them up to 1,000 employees that they have let go during their restructuring reorganization. And that's it for this week. I'm Deborah Borchardt reporting for the Green Market Report. Stay safe and healthy out there, everyone.